a summer essentials video for you. We are going to jump right in and I'm going to share with you the things that I use constantly during the summertime. All right, so the first few things are self-tanners, and you might be like, okay, Kate, why self-tanners? It's the summertime, you can just go and lay out. When I was, you know, well, actually I was still on YouTube, but I was younger, I abused the crap out of my skin, and you guys saw it. I was so dark, and it was just really, really unhealthy. So I try and stay out of the sun as much as possible. I do like to still get a little bit of a tan here and there in the summer, but generally I'm going to be using some self-tanning products to keep myself with a nice summer glow. I'm gonna just buzz through these really quickly, but my favorite self-tanner right now, I have been using the Million Dollar Tan, and I still love that one. That's the spray-on one. I think it's a Tan Icon Extreme. That one's awesome, but unfortunately, like right here on my arms, it gets a little bit scaly looking when it comes off, and so I've been kind of dabbling around trying some other things here and there. So right now my favorite is the Saint Tropez. I have been using this one not that long at all, but it gives you a really, really, really nice kind of sun-kissed color, not anything too dramatic. I don't even think this is like the dark one. This is just the regular. I'm definitely going to be trying the dark though, because I feel like, hey, it's summer, we can do that. And then I don't use the Jergens Natural Glow as a self-tanner. I use it more as like a tan extender. So what this does is it just keeps my self-tan really hydrated, so it doesn't come off looking scaly. It lasts a little bit longer and also kind of intensifies the color. So I use this in conjunction with a self-tanner. I don't really just use this alone. And let me tell you, I haven't used this for years. And so I heard people kind of starting to talk about it again. And I was like, oh, that thing, it just was orange, it didn't smell good. And I was like, it kind of had a bad reputation there for a while. So I was like, whatever, enough people are talking about it right now. I'm gonna try it again and give it a second chance. And I did, and I was pleasantly surprised. It doesn't smell like that typical nasty self-tanner smell. Actually, I was filming the other day and I had put this on and my brother came over and he went into my bathroom and he's like, what smells so good in here? I was like, I literally just took a shower and put this on. It smells so good. So this really has improved. So if it's been a few years since you've tried this, definitely give it another chance because it really is awesome. And then the last thing on my little self-tanner category is this face tanner, and this one is from Vita Liberata. Now this one is like a gradual, it's kind of the same idea as this Jergens, but it's for your face. And this one really does not give you a ton of color. It just kind of gives you a glow. So if you're looking for something that's actually going to tan your face, this is not your product. But this is a self-tanning night moisture mask, is the way it kind of markets itself. So you put it on at night, it's very, very thick and heavy, but it doesn't clog your pores, which is nice. So it gives you a lot of moisture, and then you wake up with just a nice little bit of color. So if you're someone who likes to self-tan your whole body, but you don't want to use like a tanner on your face, this is a good option so that there's not such a stark difference between your head and your the rest of your body. So I really have been enjoying this. All right, my next two things are a BB cream or a CC cream or some kind of lightweight tinted moisturizer, you know, foundation-y type stuff. I have really been liking these two from IT Cosmetics. This is the concealer. It's the Your Skin But Better CC Plus. It's the color correcting full coverage cream, anti-aging plus hydrating serum, and it has an SPF of 50. Both of these do. So I've really been liking these just for a quick, you know, if I'm going out to run errands or if I'm just going to be out in the heat and I don't want to do a full face of makeup, I'm just doing something really quick. I really do like to just kind of apply these really quickly. You can just do it with your fingers. It goes on really, really quick and very smooth, and they last a long time actually, and they work really well in high temperatures. It's been like 90s here. So these are definitely like melt proof. So I've really been enjoying these. While we're still talking about face makeup, I'm going to share with you my favorite bronzer of the moment. It is the Too Faced Chocolate Soleil bronzer. And this one has been around forever. You've heard 1.5 million people talk about it, I'm sure, but I actually had never tried this until like a week ago. So anyway, I hadn't tried this at all. I don't know where I was on this because it's an awesome product. It's just a really nice natural bronzer. It reminds me a lot of Benefit's Hoola bronzer. The shade of it, it's not overly dark, it's not orange at all. It's just a really nice chocolatey color, hence the name. And you guys, it smells amazing. If you have the Too Faced Chocolate Bar palette or the Semi-Sweet palette, or even have this, you know what I'm talking about, but it smells so good. It's like candy on your face, and who doesn't want candy on your face? Okay, so if you are going to be laying out and you want something that is going to give you a nice, really super, super bronze color, this is your product. This is the Maui Babe Browning Lotion. I got this at Ulta and I got this forever ago. This bottle has lasted me a very long time. And I pulled this out for this video and I was like, I wonder if this is expired because I've had it so long, but I don't see like an expiration date or anything on it. And it still smells the way it did when I bought it, which is not a very pleasant smell. Let me just put that out there. It does not smell that great at all, and this does not have any SPF at all in it. This is a tan accelerator. It kind of smells like molasses, if I'm just being honest. But this gives you the most amazing tan that you'll ever get in your entire life. This is way better than any, you know, like Australian Gold little spray-on tanning oil, cream, lotion kind of thing. This really, 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 really makes you tan. This does not have any SPF, so I would highly recommend maybe putting one under this, because this is basically going to take the sun rays and just suck them up towards your skin. All right, so when you have a tan, whether it be a real tan or a fake tan or anything, you're going to need an exfoliator, because it's always good to keep your skin nice and exfoliated so you don't have the scales, the dry skin scales or anything like that, just to keep your skin looking nice and healthy and allowing that tan to really glow on your skin. You don't want to have like a chalky looking tan because you have dry skin everywhere. So this has been my favorite one at the moment. This is the Soap and Glory Flake Away. It's got shea butter, sugar, and peach seed. So they call it a body polish, and it just smells so fresh and so fresh and so clean. This is what it looks like, and I usually just kind of keep this in the shower with me, and a little bit goes a long way. So you can tell I've barely even made a dent in this, but I've used it several times. All of this stuff I will have links for in the description box below. So if you want a reference point for where you can buy some of this stuff, I will have more info down there. So make sure to check if you're interested in any of this. All right, and the last thing that I'm gonna talk about as far as your skin goes, because I feel like everyone just really wants to have the perfect like summer skin. This is my favorite summer moisturizer. This is the Aloe Vera by Swedish Beauty. You can get this at tanning salons. You can get this on Amazon, eBay, but really this is a product that you're gonna find in like a tanning salon. It's not gonna be in like a drugstore or anything like that. Even in Sephora and Ulta, I haven't seen this. So I think this is just one of those specific tanning salon or online type of products. But okay, so let me tell you why I like this. I've talked about this for years, so if you've been following my channel for a while, hi, you know about this, and I'm really sorry I'm gonna be going on about it again, but if you're new to my channel and you haven't heard me talk about this, this has been like my holy grail for, I don't know, 4 or 5 years, something like that. I use this constantly. It keeps my skin ultra moisturized, but it's super duper light. The smell of this is phenomenal. This is nut, gluten, paraben, and silicone free, so if any of those bother you, you don't have to worry about this. Like I said, it's ultra light, it's ultra moisturizing, and it sinks into your skin super duper quick. And this also is marketed as a tan extender. So if you do self tan or you have an actual suntan, this is really going to help prolong the life of your tan. And it also has aloe in there. So this is the thing I was gonna mention. Not only is it good for tan extending and moisturizing, but if you've gotten a little too much sun, I always put this on, even over like aloe vera gel, to be honest with you. I always go to this first, because it just gives you that moisture, but it's got that aloe in there that's really soothing to your skin. I swear, I'll go to bed, and if I have a little bit too much sun, if I'm pink or something, I put this on and wake up and I have a tan. It's not like a burnt, it doesn't get any worse. It really does kind of help soothe the redness or, you know, the sunburn or whatever. And it's a very like cooling kind of feel when you put it on. So this is like my one-stop shop for my favorite like tan extender, moisturizer, sunburn helping products. So I really like this. If you guys have never tried it, I highly recommend it. It's a little bit pricey, but it's a huge bottle. This is an 18 fluid ounce bottle, so you definitely get a lot of use out of this. And this is like my summer number one must have. I can't do summer without this product. So the next thing is one of my favorite things. You guys know I talk about this all the time, but seriously, I just love it. It is my Yue Boom portable speaker, and this is a really rugged, durable speaker, so you can bring this with you anywhere. You can bring it to the pool, you could dunk it in the pool, and it's not gonna ruin it. I mean, you can't just let it sit around and float in there. It is water resistant, so if you accidentally dunk it in the lake or, you know, the ocean or the pool or something, it's not going to ruin the speaker. We've taken the speaker up to the pool, you know, just out at the park, on a boat, and it like powers the whole area. So if you are somewhere and you don't have speakers, especially like a boat, if you're on the lake or on the ocean or whatever you're doing, this is really awesome, because if you don't have like built-in speakers or whatever, or you're renting a boat, you need this. The next thing is a camera. Whatever camera it is, if you have one of those little Polaroid cameras, I'm jealous of you. I want one of those really bad. But any kind of camera, even if it's just your iPhone camera or if it's like a point and shoot digital camera, something to capture all of your fun summer memories. One of the ones that I use on my vlog channel is the Canon S20, and I just bought this and I really, really like this camera. It's kind of a middle of the road price range for a point and shoot camera. It's not, you know, the very low end, but it's also not the super high end. And it gives you really good quality. It's got Wi-Fi, so you can send it to your phone or your computer. So this is one that I'm really, really liking right now. There's tons of other good ones out there, but I feel like you just need to capture all of the moments of summer so you can look back on them. Another huge essential of mine is leave-in conditioners. These are my two favorite at the moment. This has been my holy grail for like ever. This is the Healthy Sexy Hair from Sexy Hair. It's the Soy Tri Wheat Leave-In. This is just a tiny little travel size. And this is what I would typically throw in my purse or beach bag or whatever if I was going to go to the pool or the lake or something like that. It's really, really important, especially since I have highlighted hair, to moisturize my hair when I'm going to be out in the sun, because that really does kind of dry your hair out. So you want to be putting back in a little bit of moisture. The other one I've really been liking, this is the It's a 10 for Blondes. So this one is just, you know, the regular leave-in conditioner. It's got a little bit of a purple tint. It kind of claims to help tone your blonde. I haven't noticed a huge amount of like toning at all from this product, but I really do like the way it makes my hair feel. It makes it feel so soft and so silky. I definitely recommend always having a little leave-in conditioner with you, whether it be the pool or the beach or, you know, the lake or whatever. You just kind of want to be putting something back into your hair so that once you get out of the water, it doesn't just dry out and not have any moisture left. So these are huge for me during the summertime. I think the last thing I was gonna mention is a pair of your favorite sunnies, and these are my favorite right now. Does every girl have to like put their sunglasses on and then just touch their hair? I think that's a thing. I love high-end sunglasses, don't get me wrong, but I'm the type of girl that throws these in my car and like sits on them and breaks them immediately. I got these last year at Target, and the fact that they are still with me is blowing my mind. I'm the type of person to just chuck my sunglasses somewhere and absolutely ruin them. So the fact that I still have these is awesome. I got them at Target for like $16, but they're really cute aviators. They have a little floral detail here on the side. The side used to be like super white. It has kind of like yellowed from being in the sun, which is kind of gross. But I really like these a lot. I feel like they match almost everything and can't go wrong with a pair of aviators. I think that was all for my summer essentials. I think I mentioned everything. I feel like I'm kind of forgetting something though. I don't know. We'll see. Like I said, I will have links for all of this in the description box below. I want to know what your summer essentials are, so leave me a comment down below and let me know some of the things that you cannot live without during the summertime. So that is it. Thank you guys, as always, so very much for watching. I love you guys so much, and I will see you in my next video. Bye!